Welcome back to our show. It's called Sister Circle Live, and today we wanted to focus on all of those extraordinary fathers out there who are dedicated to their families.
Absolutely.
Day in and day out, and we've been filled. This show has been very, very lit with the men today.
Yeah, the men are turning up.
And you know, we usually have Chef Jannard back here
in the kitchen.
But we're going to talk fatherhood today.
Absolutely.
Isn't that good?
That's a whole nother form of cooking.
And Chef, you have a tribe over there. You know, how many kids? Tell the people how many kids you got, Chef.
I have 9 kids, 5 girls and 4 boys. Yeah, so trust me, you know, it's a lot always going on. Yeah, but me and my wife, we're retired out of the business, but we still like to play the sport every now and then.
Yes, y'all.
Yes,
tell us, what's the best part of being a father?
You know, the best part of being a father is seeing these young individuals really just grow into their own, and each one of them carries a trait that's so unique of me. Like, I have one that's trying to be a businessman at a young age, another one wants to be a chef, another one's just smart, witted at the mouth, and seeing all these different personalities, and I'm thinking to myself, did I give my parents this many different things like that? Because I come from a relatively big family, but it is just amazing having that many little bodies in my household.
Yeah. 9 of them.
Yeah,
9.
I know, right?
We gotta make all the checks.
Right. Some of them get lost. Yes. What number 7 at?
Counting.
I know.
Yeah. I mean, but it's already enough pressure on you from just day to day being the person that you are, but you are a father of 9 innocent little hearts. So what kind of pressure does that put on you as a father to, number one, be so present? And what fears do you have, you know, in being that present person in your children's lives?
You know, the biggest pressure is showing up for them, not one day, but every day, learning how to bridge the gap with finding my happiness and success and helping them build their happiness and success at the same time. And it's a never-ending journey, but the thing is, I'm so thankful that I was blessed with the children that I have, and not to mention, I know you guys celebrating your anniversary. Me and my wife, Keena, just celebrated our 20th anniversary.
So,
you know, having someone beside me to fulfill that journey makes it all the more better.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about equipping your children with the wisdom and everything that they need. What is your approach to that? Because with 9 different personalities, you have to probably approach it 9 different ways.
Yeah.
And how do you make sure that message is consistent?
Yeah, and you say approach the 9 different ways. Try doubling that, because the simple thing is a lot of their personalities change on a yearly basis as they get old. And what my approach is taking each individual, and I spend quality time with them and learn how to focus on what it is that they're designing and what they want to achieve, and I build on it from that way, because I know each one is unique. I'm not trying to make them into me. I'm trying to make them into a better me.
That's good. I like that.
And what about when you see them going in the direction that is probably not the direction you would have wanted for them? How do you, and not to say that it's, you know, just a direction that's their personal direction, but a bad direction, a direction that's bad for anyone. How do you redirect your children, especially being that it's so many of them?
And that's a great question, because you know, with everything that goes on in the world today, it's so scary with seeing what can and what can't happen. And I really try to educate my kids from a standpoint of sitting them down and laying out the pros and cons to every decision they like, that they will experience and where I see them going. And I also use everything that I've been through in life to show them. I'm not afraid to let them know everything, all the strongholds, what bad decisions I may have made in life, and how my outcomes were, to help guide them in the right way. Even though I know ultimately it's always laying up on the individuals, you know, their own thought process, what they will become, what they would do, and what they get into, but I have to always point out strategically what the consequences is, and you have to learn to think beyond the moment from where you are right now.
Yes. Come down here giving us ingredients.
I love these fathers. Now, Chef, a lot of people, there are some people out there who don't have their fathers. Maybe they passed on, and maybe they're just not present at the moment. What effect do you think it has on your children that you are present, you are accounted for, you are there?
You know, I think it's a great effect to be present in your kids' life, especially from the man's standpoint, because children, our sons and our daughters, they need to have or feel that male role in their life and to fulfill that void. And one of the things is that I've always tried to implement and do, because I've been there for my children and my father was there for mine. We even take on mentorships where I take other kids that maybe lacking in their life, and I try to impart and share wisdom into them. So I look at it as, it's not I'm not just a father of nine, I'm a father of many, because I have to lead the example for so many others out there that may be missing that key element.
Right. How do you do, are you a whooper? How do you discipline?
I know, right?
Yes.
You know, I do believe in spare the rod, spoil the seed. But as my kids have really gotten older, you know, I think they probably think, oh, dad's getting too old to be running and chasing us behind. So they really try to behave in a way. And what I started doing, instead of using a belt, I learned to use words. And because we're in such a techie world now, I learned that, hey, I can do punishment by restricting you from things, by taking things. I remind them every day. I still pay the bills when you do something. I'm saying, give me that phone, and they say, hey, it's my phone.
It
ain't never your phone until you start paying the bills.
Many of phones.
Okay. Yeah. Exactly.
And I remove doors.
Phones, games, the whole nine. No, you can't go out. You can't go hang with your friends. I have several that have their driver's license stuff. You won't be taking any cars from this home until we can work on where it is that you need to be, and that you have a full sound understanding of it. Because it's not just saying I get it just to get out of it.
Right.
I need to see the action showing that you truly get whatever the mistake was.
Make them earn stuff.
It came down here.
Well, see, that's what I be trying to say. That's that good parenting right
there.
I don't believe in whooping and beating children. I just feel like, you know, I was whooped, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not saying that my mother was a bad mother. I don't. I feel like all parents did what they needed to do. And some kids were off the chain. You did what you needed to do to do, you know, to discipline your children. But I feel like as our world has evolved and progressed, there are different ways that you can discipline your child that is more effective. Mm-hmm. Because there are children that have been whooped and beat and still did not turn out like you thought they were going to.
Exactly.
So I love how you said that, especially as a man, because men are the number one who, no, beat the child. So I'm glad that you said that.
Yes. So, and thank you for being a present father, and thank you for being here and sharing your words of wisdom on fatherhood with us here today. We are just very grateful. We're not letting you go because you have to cook in the kitchen with Ms.
Gwynn. Yeah. Oh, yeah. 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 Right.
Get to eat ingredients on fatherhood. Get the ingredients together in the kitchen. Okay?
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live, and just like we told you at the table, we were not letting Chef Jannard go, and so he's here with us cooking up something special in the kitchen, as you are a very special father and you take care of your children, which we love and adore that. But what are we cooking up today? What do you have here, Chef?
Oh man, looking to kick up your barbecue in a different way. We're going to do a pineapple barbecue jackfruit.
I like that, with us being on the heels of the 4th of July.
Yeah, you know it, because you know we're going to be saturated with a lot of meat. We're going to have chicken, seafood, ribs, the whole nine.
Right.
So this right here, take it down a notch. Also beautiful to go on that table setting as well. It's a little more on the lighter side.
And that's
what I always want to share with people.
Now let's tell the people what jackfruit is. It's known in some areas as jacktree.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And it comes from, the jackfruit comes from the fig and mulberry tree.
Absolutely.
But the cool thing about it is, you know, it's low glycemic, you know, it's high in fiber, and it's a very good fruit. And the thing is, it's a fruit that allows you to create the taste however you want it. You can make it taste like chicken, pork, all of it.
The flavors around it.
Almost like a pasta, except it's a fruit.
Yeah.
And see, I'm upset that over there. That's some jackfruit I already had marinating.
You gotta marinate it with barbecue sauce.
Yeah, and what we're gonna do is, we're gonna add in a little Thai chili sauce, a little sweet Thai chili there.
Real good, like that.
And an actual little spicy barbecue sauce.
Oh, I like spicy.
And I always say, you know, the spices open up the flavor profile of it.
Mm-hmm.
And while you're stirring that up, you can actually pass me a spoon there, please, ma'am.
Okay, you need a spoon there.
Yes,
you go.
A spoon there. And then
I want the pineapples too.
No, pineapples are for you. They're going to go in there, and then you're going to add those bell peppers. I know. It's good and sweet.
So good.
Yes, it's the right season.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you notice what I did with the pineapple, what you do is you cut the pineapple in half, and then you just do little dices on the inside of
it.
Yes, and once you do those dices, it allows you to just take your spoon, just carve out the center of this
Chef,
bad
you
boy.
You want to go ahead and put the chives in?
Yes, you do.
Right,
yes,
do
chives, your
and
bell
peppers.
And the thing is, you know how normally, we as the guys, we typically out on the grill, fight mm-hmm. with the grill. So this is a cool dish that the ladies can do on the inside of the house.
Or
if the guy saying it's too hot
too.
And he don't want to go outside, he can do this dish from inside as well.
Okay, I like that. Now, I'm going to go ahead and get this all good and mixed mm-hmm. in. Now, Les, the people tell me you're going to be mixed in down there at the Essence Festival.
You better believe it.
Along I'm coming with
down. Yes, indeed. We're going to be down there repping it on the Essence East stage.
Yes.
I'm coming down whipping it up in my BMW X7.
Okay.
Trying to make it do what it do.
Okay, man.
Representing Cleo, which is our sister network. You
Absolutely.
Better ask somebody.
I done asked them.
Yeah, and you know what I'm doing? I'm cooking a cool dish that I'm gonna be whipping up on stage.
What are you making?
Man, it's actually it's a chicken marsala dish that I'm making.
Ooh, I love
then
chicken
I'm gonna do a keto mint mojito
ooh,
for the audience. So show them how. Yeah, because you know everybody's on the keto tip now. So I'm gonna show how you still can take in all the good beverages and be on the lighter side.
Too, for yeah. Because you know New Orleans don't play with the heat. It's hot like fire.
Oh man, yeah, it's hot than a camel in the Sahara Desert.
Okay then, how about that? And I think what I'm gonna make down at Essence East, at the Essence East stage, I'm gonna make my coconut shrimp with spicy orange sauce.
Oh, now see, now you're
like
talking
that.
To me.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking
yeah.
about. Well, you already know where I'm going to be hanging at. Right there, side by stage. Just throw me a couple of scraps down.
I got
now,
you, baby.
Now, what you want to do after you hollow out your pineapples, you fill your pineapples mm-hmm. actually with rice. And it could be any kind of rice that you like fixing. Let me turn that heat off
yeah.
for you now.
This is ready. And I just top this
yep,
with?
White rice, brown rice, dirty rice, whatever kind of rice
ooh,
you
I like.
You know, cooking is about bringing people into your world.
Absolutely.
And then after your jackfruit, and one of the things you'll notice, the jackfruit texture is almost like a pulled pork
absolutely.
Chicken. Yeah, so you bring it into your world,
I like
just
that.
Bring that in. See how we work so well together
in the
kitchen?
We do, Chef. You know, we get it going on in the
exactly.
kitchen.
Exactly. I like this right here. Let's hit the top of that with a little more of those
green sky. Yes,
yeah, there you go.
Mm-hmm. Hey, everybody.
Hey. Oh, y'all just in time. I got whole jackfruit.
So
I got
beautiful.
One over there for you. Ooh. Then we got one right here.
Give me a little something on the plate. Something to pass you.
This
something.
Right here.
Plate, baby.
There you go. We're going to let you hold it since you're saying, what is it there? That's a pineapple jackfruit.
And
barbecue let's talk jackfruit.
And this
stuff.
Is healthy.
Yeah.
So for a person like Selena who's training for competition right
this
now, could
one.
This be something that she can have?
Oh, absolutely. You know, if you're training for a competition, one of the things is there's no meat base in it's all vegetable.
That's
the only
really
starch
good.
That you're getting out of it is from the rice mm-hmm. with some form of starches in your body you know are good for
yes.
you. But at the same time, if you're looking to feel light and you want to be able to burn off the energy a lot faster, this is definitely a way to
that's
go.
For you, baby.
And
yes,
you'll also be fulfilled.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, exactly. Because that's one of the things we typically look for whenever that we're eating. We're mm-hmm. always looking for something that has a great flavor profile.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, mm-hmm. we want that substance afterwards.
Right.
And
mm-hmm.
this is what you can eat and it won't stick to you afterwards.
Oh, and
that's good.
You don't have to compromise on
oh,
the flavor.
Oh, that's good.
That's the key. I say you should never sacrifice flavor or taste for what it is that you say. See what I'm saying? We getting dancing moves.
That's what we do when we get something that's
so
good
I'm just,
to
well,
eat.
I got to blow my whole thing. It's from
I know, right?
Right here.
It's got that spice and sweet.
You
and,
like
and,
that?
And you know, the spice is designed to really open up the flavor profile so you can really taste all the ingredients. If you notice, you get notes of the spice, the sweetness from the Thai chili, from the pineapple, the zest from the jackfruit.
And he's still talking.
And
I love him to death.
It all in.
I love him to death. Children, you know you're my man, 100 grand. I tell you that right now. Listen, if you are at Essence, please join us both right
yes.
at the
yes.
Essence East main stage. And you can also find him every Saturday at 2:00 hanging out on Cleo.
Yes.
Just cooking up a little
kitchen.
Something for the people. We'll be right back.
Nice job. That's good right there.